speaker is Ed Reyes.
Good evening, commissioners, mayor. Here on behalf of the Gainesville General Assembly, it was created in support of the New York City General Assembly, which of course has been occupying Wall Street for now 3 weeks, going on 3 weeks. And I want to invite you all to join us as part of the 99%. It's clear that our government is in dire need of change, the way that policy is run. I want to tell you all that we do have a focus. We have very clear goals, despite what the media might tell you. The media calls us unorganized. That's far from the truth. We formed 11 committees to tackle all the issues that we're facing. I want to read a couple things about who we are. In solidarity with the ongoing Occupy Wall Street movement, Occupy Gainesville begins this Wednesday, October 12th, at 8 a.m. at the Bo Diddley Plaza. The occupation is scheduled to go on indefinitely. The Occupy Gainesville General Assembly, which will consist of anyone and everyone who shows up to participate, will decide collectively on its primary demands, including some on specific local issues. There is no single leader or governing body of the General Assembly. Everyone is equal. That includes you guys. So again, I hope to see you there. And anyone is free to propose an idea or express an opinion as part of the General Assembly. Then we'll debate the idea. And if there is no consensus, we'll ask the person who presented the idea to come back for the next general meeting with a better worked out idea, if they so wish to do. This is very important times. I think we can all agree on that. There's a lot going on in the world. And I want to remind you where we got here, or how we got here, sorry. Woodrow Wilson, on December 23rd, 1913, passed the Federal Reserve Act, which gave the power of printing money to a group of private bankers. In case you don't know this, it is not a federal entity. The Federal Reserve is not a federal entity. It's a for-profit, privately run corporation, and they're what we can call the 1%. And Woodrow Wilson said this in my last few seconds. I am a most unhappy man. I have unwittingly ruined my country. A great industrial nation is controlled by its system of credit. Our system of credit is concentrated. The growth of the nation, therefore, and all of our activities are in the hands of a few men. We have come together as one of the worst ruled, one of the most completely controlled and dominated governments in the civilized world. No longer a government by free opinion, no longer a government by conviction and the vote of the majority, by a government by the opinion and duress of a small group of dominant men. We hope to right these wrongs and correct what's been going on here for over a century. Thank you. I appreciate your time. Thank you for listening.
Next speaker is Debbie Martinez.
Mayor, commissioners, my name is Debbie Martinez. Our government is sick. As a registered nurse, you treat the disease, not the symptoms, to get well. The disease is corporate funding of elections. Politicians spend most of their time raising money for their campaigns. Wall Street and corporations get the privilege of drafting legislation, giving themselves obscene tax cuts and subsidies. Symptoms include poverty and unemployment, which cannot be fixed until you treat the disease. There is a cure. Last week, Dylan Radigan, an investigative reporter with a team of constitutional lawyers, drafted a constitutional amendment to abolish corporate funding of elections. This petition is now online at getmoneyout.com. Please take the time and sign the petition. Wall Street spends the most on campaigns, which led to the largest financial crisis since the Great Depression. Both Republicans and Democrats deregulated our financial industry. Congress legalized the theft. These huge bank losses continue to be passed on to us, the taxpayers. We do not have a free market. This is corporate welfare. The healthcare sector gives billions to campaigns as well. Individual private health care insurance is like a Ponzi scheme. Pay your bloated premiums, get sick, then get dumped. Their profits skyrocket when they deny you care. That is why this petition is so important. Medicare costs continue to rise, not because our parents are standing in line to get their kidneys removed. Costs are high because medical providers and suppliers are charging inflated prices and charging for services never received. Republicans and Democrats allow this taxpayer theft because the healthcare sector fund the campaigns. If they just cut the theft in half, we could provide low-cost Medicare for all, a system that does not punish people when they become sick or injured. You cannot fix this with simple campaign finance reform. That's like telling an alcoholic it's okay to have just one drink. You have to amend the Constitution and abolish corporate funding of elections. Signing the petition at getmoneyout.com starts the process. Then we can enact mandatory true public financing of elections. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Actually, we do not allow applause or boos for anyone's comments, so that everyone will have the ability to speak freely. Next speaker, Pat Fitzpatrick.
Pat Fitzpatrick, civil indigence declared by the courts, failure in a capitalist corporate system, proud of it. Every five seconds, a child dies of hunger-related disease in this world, so 36 people are going to die, 36 children are going to die in the time I'm speaking here today. And it's our fault. It's our fault, not your fault. One finger at you, three at me. It's none of us would go outside this door if we saw a hungry child. All of us would feed him. But as a society, we have a lot of work to do. Saw that work start yesterday, right out front here. I saw democracy in action. 200 people calling themselves the General Assembly had a lot of things to say about what's going on. One of you was even there yesterday. I'm not going to mention who it was because I don't want the Gang of Four, which are the four corporate developers, downtown developers over here, to find out. You know, we don't want them to find out because they get awful mad. It is amazing how those four people, how much power they have in this city. I'm going to read you the Declaration of the Occupation of New York City, and it goes for here, too. As we gather together in solidarity to express a feeling of mass injustice, we must not lose sight of what brought us together. We write so that all people who feel wronged by the corporate forces of the world can know that we are your allies. As one people united, we acknowledge the reality that the future of the human race requires a cooperation of its members, that our system must protect our rights and those of their neighbors, that a democratic government derives its just power from the people, but corporations do not seek consent to extract wealth from the people and the earth, and that no true democracy is obtainable when the process is determined by economic power. We come to you at a time when corporations, which place profits over people, self-interest over justice, and oppression over equality, run our government. We are peacefully assembled here, and it is our right, and we will let the facts be known. On December 2nd, 1964, on the steps of Sproul Plaza in Berkeley, California, my brother and comrade Mario Savio said this: "There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, it makes you so sick at heart that you can't take part. You can't even passively take part. And you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels and upon the levers and upon all the apparatuses. And you've got to make it stop. And you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will permanently prevent you from working at all." The machine is here in Gainesville. 8 o'clock Wednesday morning, we're occupying the Bo Diddley Plaza. Everybody be there. Everybody be there. It is our plaza. We can stay as long as we want. We will occupy that. And we'll be at the next city commission meeting when they see how you deal with 200 people at public comment.
Members of the city commission, does anyone wish to speak to any of the items that were raised? Yes, Commissioner Wells.
I just want to say I was out down on City Hall Plaza yesterday, and it was a very positive group of citizens. And, you know, even though I think I have some disagreement with a lot of what's said here and there as well, maybe, I also heard many citizens' very heartfelt pleas and, know, I appreciate the meetings that are going on. We just came back from a trip in which people on a much more challenging conflict, our friends in Israeli community and our friends in the Palestinian community, are themselves trying to figure out how to resolve a conflict peacefully in the face of, I would suggest, a lot more difficult and challenging circumstances than we face here in Gainesville. And as I recall, they said 400,000 Israelis were in the street doing something similar to the Occupy Wall Street movement out of a country of about 7.5 million people, something like that. It's quite an impressive number. There are few of them were still there even when we were there last week, even in Kfar Saba, which is a little town about the size of Gainesville. So anyhow, I certainly took note of these. I don't know if I'll be able to attend all of them, but I think, you know, I wanted to put into context, at least in what I'd seen in the last week and a half, an appreciation of the citizens of Gainesville and the work that you're doing, whether or not you agree with everything that's happening in City Hall or not, and your particular willingness to come here and articulate that. So thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Commissioner Wells. Commissioner Chase.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. To the same group, I would appreciate your comments, Commissioner Wells, and I would encourage you later tonight, we're going to vote on the election dates and the qualifying. So I'd also encourage you to find someone to step up like Mr. Save has and run for office because of the things he believes. Because that's important, and that's why I ran, and here I am. So find somebody and you know, go for it. I'm going to go to the forum on Sunday. I plan on listening. I'm going to go. I'm going to go to the RUC meeting Monday, so that's going to be coming up. And I would encourage any commissioner who's not on the RUC to maybe try to go, because it's going to be a very informative meeting, and I think it's going to impact some discussions and decisions that we have down the road, because it is our job, in my view, to manage this thing going forward. So that's, but I'll be going Sunday and seeing how that goes, and I look forward to it. Thanks.
Thank you, Commissioner Chase. Anyone else wish to speak to an item that was raised during citizen comment? Okay. Do any of the charters wish to speak to anything that was raised during citizen comment? Okay, seeing none, Mr. Clerk.